Welcome children, to another session of a crop production and management. Yesterday we have discussed about the crop, then we have discussed about the cropping pattern which is followed by the farmer. It is of two type, kharif crop and rabi crop. Then we have discussed the basic practice of crop production, which can divide it into seven steps. First one, preparation of a soil. Second one, sowing of a seed. Third one, adding manure and fertilizer. Fourth one, irrigation. Fifth one, protecting from weeds. Sixth one, harvesting. And seventh one, storage. So now we are going to discuss the first point, that is a preparation of soil. So preparation of a soil, it is the first step before growing a crop. It is important to turn the soil and loosen it. This allow the root to penetrate deep into the soil. That is means if soil is very hard, then the plant's root cannot penetrate the soil particle and absorb sufficient amount of a nutrition and soil. Whereas if we loosen the soil, then plant root can easily go deep into the soil and get sufficient amount of a nutrition and water. Loose soil allow the root to breathe easily even when they go deeper into the soil. You have heard the word breathe. That means that root can breathe. They can also take the oxygen from the soil particle, because oxygen always present in the soil particles. That's why their root can absorb oxygen properly if it is properly turn and loosen. You know, the turning and loosening the soil bring the nutrient rich soil to the top, which is again utilized by the plant. If you see, before turning and loosening the soil, you will see that the nutrients are very deep inside the soil, which is not utilized by the root of a plant. But after turning and loosening the soil, you will find out these nutrients, which is very deep, are coming top of the soil and which is utilized by the soil very easily. You know, one more thing, some microorganisms and earthworms live inside the soil, and you know, the earthworm is also called farmer's friend because they help to turn and loosen the soil and add humus to the soil. One more thing, when plant and animal die, they release all their nutrients into the soil, and these nutrients again absorbed by the plant. So the process of loosening and turning of the soil is called tilling or plowing, and this is done by using plow. It is made up of wood or metal. So this is a structure of plow. Now what will happen after the plowing? After the plowing, the field have a big crumbs, means ye mitti ke bahut bade bade dhele type hote hain, which can be further broken down, and this can be broken down with the help of a wooden plank. Plank help to break crumbs and level the field into the finest particle. After leveling, we add some manure to the soil so it will mix properly into the soil. For preparation of a soil, farmers require some agricultural implement, and what are these? These all are agricultural implement which is used by the farmers. The first one is a plow, the second one is a hoe, and third one is a cultivator. Plow you have seen at the back. The plow can use to tilling the soil, adding fertilizers, removing weeds, scraping of a soil, and it can be pulled by the bull or the tractor. The next thing is a hoe. Hoe is a long rod of wood or iron. Broad and bent plate of iron is fixed to one of its end and work like a blade. It is pulled by animal. This is a structure. This is a plate which can be helped to remove weeds and loosening the soil. And this beam can be attached by the tractor or the bulls, which can pull and removing weeds and loosening the soil. The last one is a cultivator. Actually, the cultivator is a modern plow which can be called drive-in cultivator, and it will pull by the tractor, and this is a structure of cultivator. So this is a first part of preparation of a soil. The second part is a sowing of seed. So now we are moving to the next heading, that is a sowing of seed. Sowing is the most important part of a crop production. Before sowing, farmers select good quality of a seed. So why there is a need to select the good quality of seed? I will give you one example. Just like that, I will give you a one beet plant which can produce 10 beet seed with high requirement of a water and high requirement of a fertilizer. Whereas another beet plant produce 20 beet seed with less water and no fertilizer. So which one you select? I hope the second one you will select to increase your production. Same farmers can also choose good quality seed to increase their production. Before sowing, one of the important task is to know about the tool used for sowing the seed. So before sowing the seed, we will understand some tools which is utilized by the farmer. The first one is a traditional tool. What is this? Traditional tool, it's shaped like a funnel. Seed are filled into the funnel, passes down through two or three pipes having sharp end. These end pierce in the soil and place seeds there. If you see, this is a funnel like structure through which we will put the seed, and these seed will passes through these four pipe like structure and go deep into the soil. That is how the traditional tool will use. But nowadays the modern method, that is called a seed drill. Nowadays the seed drill is used for sowing with the help of a tractor. Now what is the benefit seed drill over a traditional tool? Benefit: sows seed uniformly at proper distance. Second, it ensures that seed get covered by the soil after sowing. Third one, it save time and labor. So this is a benefit of a seed drill over a traditional tool. So today we have discussed about the preparation of a soil. Then we have discussed how the crumbs will be broken down into the finest soil. Then we have discussed the agricultural implement which is used by the farmer, that is a plow, hoe and cultivator. Then we have discussed the next part, that is a sowing, and in it we will discuss the traditional tool and seed drill. Thank you.